Now, this next feature, I could not be any happier about because this is, oh, it's so helpful. Guys, I hope you are ready to transform your iPad experience because Apple just wrapped up WWDC and iPadOS 18 is nothing short of game-changing with the number of features that they announced today. From smart note-taking to immersive gaming, I think iPadOS 18 has got something for everyone, whether you're a student, creative, everyday user. Let's dive into my favorite features coming to iPadOS 18. Starting with number one, whether you are an avid note taker or you are just getting into taking handwritten notes, Smart Script and Notes is the ability to smooth out and straighten handwritten notes no matter how bad your handwriting is. These can be taken using your Apple Pencil, they can be copied and pasted from another text app into the Notes app. You could quickly scribble out notes and be confident that your handwriting will always be legible by the system. It will go ahead and reflow it either to fit, you can make inline corrections on spelling, and scribble out to erase, which is very cool if you are a student, creative, professional, using your iPad in the workplace to take notes. Now, number two is very cool to demonstrate. Here we got the calculator app, which is brand new for iPadOS 18. You open it up, you have the basic calculator, you also have a scientific calculator. These are all the same functions that you see on the iPhone version, but now you have math notes. Now watch this. Here I'm gonna open up math notes, and I'm gonna say, what is 10 times 5? And then it should solve it, which it does. So there's part of the equation. Now I'm gonna hold down on this 5, and now it brings up a slider. I can change this value. It will change it in real time, which is so freaking cool. Listen, when I was a kid, it was all about how cool your scientific calculator was. And now they have this. This is like awesome. Anyways, you could type or write any mathematical expression, solve them instantly, and graph the equations in real time using the new calculator with math notes. Let's talk about number three, which are enhancements coming to messages in iPadOS. So first and foremost, we have to recognize that Apple's now supporting RCS standard, which is the ability to cross message people with Android phones and have high quality media and a lot of the effects that you get inside of messages. Second, you get schedule send messages. So I can schedule a time to send you a message. I can have the message effects for animated messages, react with emoji or stickers, the ability to use formatting, so it's underline, bold, italics, and strike through in messages as well, and the ability to create your own genmojis, as they're calling them, in iPadOS 18. And I think my favorite one from that is going to be the text effects that you can add for the different messages. Next up, it's for the young professionals out there. You get the ability to summarize, rewrite, proofread text across first-party and third-party apps. Take a snippet of text and have it either expand on it, you can have it summarize it, make it succinct. That's a great for people if you're looking for a different way to have your message come across. And let me know down in the comments below if you're using an AI chatbot or something like that by dropping a robot emoji down in the comments below. Next, I couldn't believe that Apple was going to let us customize our home screens until they were on stage talking about it. So new in iPadOS 18 is the ability to personalize your home screen. You can customize this. You get the different icons along the bottom. I could change the icon size. I can make sure that it's gonna match. I could change the icon color, the tinting. It's actually kind of cool. And it works for both light mode, dark mode, or you can make them permanently dark. There are a number of other changes coming to this as well, which I'll demonstrate in a future video, so make sure you're subscribed for that. Next up, Apple's bringing password management cross-platform, so you have the ability to manage your passwords either within your iPad, your iPhone, your Mac, even bring into Windows via the iCloud application that is downloadable from the Windows Store. And now you're getting the ability to securely store credentials, verification codes, security alerts, Wi-Fi passwords, as well as share them with friends and family for easy access. I love the changes coming to the Photos app with the different organized libraries, the themes, and the carousel view. So here, this is just browsing by the water. You also got trips, feature photos, wallpaper suggestions. So there's a number of cool changes coming to the Photos app. Top line, this is a very cool feature, especially if you use your iPhone to take a lot of your photos, which I imagine a lot of you probably do. And then they have these organized in such a way where you are getting to the good stuff without necessarily going through all the receipts and the pictures of like you mistakenly taking of your foot or something like that. But I love this, and I think these are well worth changes coming to the Photos app. Now, this next feature is coming to Safari, and this is the ability to use machine learning inside of Safari to summarize articles and provide key information about the website that you're visiting. Essentially, what you do is you click on the summarize button and it provides you of what you need to know about this website. It's not working as of right now on the Verge's website, but I imagine that as the beta goes on, you know, it's the first day, things will continue to improve and work throughout that. Additionally, now I've never seen this feature, but you can have Siri read you the article on the webpage.
iMessage is getting some other upgrades too, including the ability
That's to wild. That's probably like a under the radar, probably my favorite feature right now. Now this next feature I could not be any happier about because this is, it's so helpful. Now I play the tech support role for my family. My friends, my family, they call me and say, Mike, how do I use my Mac? How do I use my iPhone? If that's not you, I'm sorry, you could skip ahead, but if that sounds like you, stay tuned. Well now, new in iPadOS 17 with SharePlay, you have the ability to draw someone's attention when you're screen sharing to a certain part of the screen. So the scenario is, your mom calls you, your dad calls you saying, hey, I can't log into this website. You say, okay, well click here. They're like, well, where's here? You use your mouse or use your finger and just, or the Apple Pencil now, and you say, hey, click right here, and you circle it on the screen. They're like,
oh, I see it now.
This is awesome. This is like a total time saver because I might do this 2 or 3 times a month, no joke. So I love that they're bringing this to iPadOS 17 or iPadOS 18 with SharePlay. I am super stoked about it because it is a giant time saver. Now this next feature you are sure to love if you are a visual thinker. I am totally a visual thinker. And these are changes coming to Freeform. So two features. So first is the ability to set scenes. And scenes are gonna be little segments of your board. So here I have a start, stop, continue board. And if I wanted to go to the next section and tell a story, I could create a scene for this board right here. All right, let's create a scene. Boom, so that create a scene. And now I can then, when I'm presenting, just automatically click the advance button and it goes right to the next scene, opposed to me having to like swipe through this giant infinite canvas. So that's very helpful. And then second is that you can present your Freeform board very easily by having a sharing link, which is well. I love using Freeform. It's actually probably the way that I am able to draw connections between things very easily. And I like using diagram tools. So if you are a visual thinker, let me know because I have a number of different boards I've created for status updates, for start, stop, continues, like continuous learning, continuous integration. But let me know if you'd like to see a video on that in the future. And finally, if all work and no play makes you a very boring person, you need a little bit of fun in your life, this last feature is for you. And this is game mode. Game mode, what it does is it basically takes every system application or system resource that's going on in that moment and pauses it. So when you play a game, you can have the best experience, including low latency Bluetooth audio and controllers. This is gonna be great for all those new games that are coming out this fall. I think they're Assassin's Creed, but that one just came out maybe about a week ago, and there's a new Assassin's Creed coming out, I think in the fall as well. So that does it for the 9 features that I think that you need to know about related to the iPad and iPadOS 18. I wanna know what is your favorite feature, whether I talked about it, whether I didn't talk about it. Drop it down below in the comments and make sure you're subscribed because I got more videos coming just like this related to the iPad, as well as full feature walkthroughs of the iPhone and the iPad. My name is Mike, and I will talk to you guys in the next one.